The learning objective of this section is to ensure relevant personnel are acquainted with the purpose of crude oil washing, the property of crude oil, the dissolving effect in crude oil, applicability of the requirements, advantages and disadvantages with crude oil washing, disadvantages with water washing, MARPOL 7378 recognises that crude oil washing provides a means of reducing the contact between oil and water. Washing cargo tanks with crude oil reduces the amount of water washing needed for those tanks required for ballast and eliminate it for sludge control purposes. Virtually all crude oil contains relatively heavy components of waxy and asphaltic substances. During a tanker's loaded passage, these components settle out and horizontal members of tank structures acquire substantial coatings of sludge deposits. After the oil is discharged from tanks, the majority of this sludge will remain. Unless it is removed, it will build up over several voyages and eventually impede the efficient drainage of the tanks. This will effectively reduce the cargo carrying capacity of the ship. Crude oil has the property of being able to dissolve its own residues, dispense and suspend the sediments in the cargo, and thus restore the cargo to the original condition when loaded. This property is the basis of crude oil washing, CoW, which, as the description implies, involves the cleaning or washing of cargo tanks with high-pressure jets of crude oil. Part of the cargo is circulated through fixed piping and washing machines during cargo discharge. Cleaning with water gives reasonable good results only when water jets with sufficient impact force are directly hitting the surface within a tank. Accordingly, the cleaning effect is almost non-existent as far as reflected jets and drainages are concerned. When using crude oil, a surprisingly good cleaning result is obtained even from drainages and reflected jets of crude oil, the so-called splashback effect. The superiority of crude oil to water as a tank cleaning fluid is exclusively dependent upon the dissolving property of crude oil. It is not possible to dissolve sediments from crude oil cargoes with water. By 1977, crude oil washing had been widely adopted by a large number of major oil companies and independent tanker owners as a means of sediment control. It was offered as an alternative to the fitting of segregated ballast tanks, SBT. The International Conference on Tanker Safety and Pollution Prevention, convened in London during February 1978, resulted in protocols amending those of the International Convention for the Safety of Life at Sea, 1974, SOLAS, and the International Convention for the Prevention of Pollution from Ships, MARPOL, 73-78. Briefly, existing crude oil carriers must be fitted with SBT systems if they are 40,000 deadweight tons or above. But as an alternative, crude oil washing, CAW, or a clean ballast tank system, CBT, may be allowed. In the case of CBT, the ship owner declares certain cargo tanks as dedicated clean ballast tanks, and these are not allowed to carry cargo. A CBT system is similar to an SBT system, except that the pumps and lines serving the CBT tanks may also be used for cargo operations. Advantages with crude oil washing. Considerable reduction in pollution potential, since less oil remains on board after discharge and less oil contaminated water is handed during the ballast passage. Reduction in time and cost of tank cleaning. De-sludging by hand obviated. Reduced tank cleaning time at sea. Increased outturn of cargo. Reduced dead freight, as less oil, water and slops are retained on board. Less salt water discharged to refineries. Tank corrosion due to water washing is reduced. Disadvantages with crude oil washing. Increased workload during discharging. Prolonged time for discharging. Costs for extra personnel. Costs for crude oil washing equipment. Potential safety and pollution risk. More equipment, higher demand for maintenance. Disadvantages with water washing. Longer time for washing each tank, resulting in increased bunker costs. Handling larger amounts of water is costly and causes increased pollution of the sea, since the water is contaminated with oil, even when load-on-top procedure is used. Increased corrosion due to extensive water washing. Reduced cargo capacity due to larger slop quantity. Discharge of more salt water with slops to refineries. longer period of time needed to prepare tanks for dry dock, or intermediate cold or hot work, tank inspection included. Radical.